Hi there, my name's Jake from Nav Boys, and today we're going to be doing an LXNAV S100 unboxing. So the LXNAV S100 is an incredibly upgradable device. It's excellent for connecting to other devices such as your Farman UDI. Straight off the bat, you've got the most capable Vario that LXNAV offer. This is a brand new LXNAV S100 standalone Vario, and we're going to show you what's included in the box. So, first thing we've got is a packing list. This describes everything that you would expect to see when it arrives. So really useful for making sure everything's there. And then next to that, we've got the calibration chart. This is a really important piece of paper, and this is what you'd need for claiming your badges, any record flights, or flying in competitions. So let's get to the interesting stuff. In here, we've got the harness. The S100 and the S80 range, they run on the CAN bus protocol. Really important to make sure you use the correct harness. That's a CAN bus harness. We've got a GPS antenna. Being an IGC approved flight recorder means that it needs its own GPS antenna. The S80, you wouldn't expect to see that. We've got a USB stick, which has all the manuals on. We've got a Bluetooth antenna and two spare screws in case you've got a really thick panel. And in here, we've got a speaker. That's for the audio Vario and also for flarm warnings or any voice warnings, they'll come through the speaker. And then lastly, we've got the Vario itself. Looking at the front of the unit, we've got the two collet nuts here. Now these are wound all the way out for transit to basically make sure that they can't accidentally be pressed while it's being shipped. The S100 has an internal battery, so if these buttons were pressed, it would turn on and it would run down the battery. So looking at down the top, we've got the top rotary switch and it's pressable as well. We've got three push buttons on the side of the display. And then at the bottom, we've got the bottom rotary switch, which is twist and press as well. Going over the top, we've got the serial number for the S100. And in brackets, we've got the IGC serial number. You'll need the IGC serial number to claim badges or records. And then going over the back, we've got the three pressure ports along the top, total energy, pitot and static. Then we've got a gold connector on the top, which is the Bluetooth antenna, which is that little toothpick antenna, and that just push fits in. We've then got a gold connector down this side here. That is for the GPS antenna. And that is just a screw fit connector. Only needs to be done finger tight on that one. So the 6-pin port is where you connect your flarm, and that allows data transfer and also power to the flarm. The 8-pin port on the right here, that is for the connecting to an UDI or connecting to an UDN with a dongle. And then going down the bottom, this is where you plug in the harness. Like so. And last but not least, we've got the Vario speaker, which just plugs over this side. Okay, time to turn it on. Top rotary switch, we just need to press in. And we're just running it on its internal battery here. And that's now started the boot up. As it boots up, you've got the serial number and the firmware versions. And then this is where you would select the profile. So this is just the default profile as it arrives from the factory. To select the profile, we would use the bottom rotary switch and then press in. And then the next page is to set the elevation, the airfield elevation that you're starting at. Really important to do this properly. Then you've got good data to start the flight. It boots up on the info page. At the top of the info page, we've got the GPS status of the device. And we've also got the, if you had a flarm connected, you'd also be able to see how many flarm targets is being received. And then at the bottom of this page, you'd be able to see the external battery voltage and also the status of the internal battery and how much capacity it's got left. To go onto the next page, you press the middle button. And this is the waypoint page. It's got WPT at the top. Onto the next page again. That's the task page. Press the middle button again, and now you go on into the setup. To scroll through the setup, we use the bottom rotary switch. and we'll start at the top. At the top, we've got the QNH and reserve altitude settings. To leave any menu, you can just press the middle button. And then going down, this is where you can set various useful bits of information. One of the important ones are files. This is where you'll be able to set the airspace and waypoints that you wish to use. And then going down further still, another really useful one is the hardware setup. And this is where you would enable the communication between an UDI and a FLAM. We're going to talk a little bit later in a later video about how you would set that up. Polar, that's for setting the polar of the glider. Really important to do that before you go flying. And then at the bottom, you've got an about page, which is useful for seeing the serial number and firmware versions. The LXNAV S100 Standalone Vario is ideal for beginners and experts alike. The reason being is it gives you all of the hardware straight off the bat. So you've got a really capable Standalone Vario. You've got an IGC flight recorder for claiming badges, and you can also have the or enable the AHARS option should you wish to go and fly in cloud in the future. But it's also so much more upgradable. You can choose to upgrade to Hawk and get Hawk Wind, which gives you much better and more accurate wind calculations, as well as another Vario algorithm. And there are lots of hardware upgrades that you can use with the S100. So you can get a radio bridge, which means that if your radio is buried right at the bottom of the panel, it's difficult to use in flight. You can control it through the S100, which is useful. It's also useful because you can get a remote stick with the S100, which then makes both the S100 and your radio even more accessible and easy to use in flight. The S100 can also take in remote inputs. So if you've got an air brake warning sensor, an undercarriage warning sensor, that can all be wired in, and the S100 will give you voice warnings about opening your air brakes without the gear down, for example. The S100 also has a built-in backup battery. If your power supply was to fail in the glider, you've got 3 hours battery life, which is really useful for getting you home, still gives you an audio Vario, and keeps your flight recorder going, so you haven't completely sort of lost your flight. The S100 also has Bluetooth built-in, which allows it to go on to communicate with an UDI or your mobile phone running CU Navigator. And again, the S100's Vario data and wind data would then get passed through to those devices, giving you really good final glide information on those devices. That's the LXNAV S100, the flagship standalone Vario from LXNAV. It's got excellent upgradability in the future, and it's got the best connectivity for connecting to FLAM and UDI devices. Stay tuned for more videos.